complications from the burns themselves, because now we have an idea of the burns, we have an idea of first through fourth degree, we've seen the rule of nines, but then there's complications that start to set in. So let's go ahead and we'll put up that graphic and we'll get a chance to look at this here. And the first one is the one I think that is rather common sense in many ways. When you're burned, piece of skin is away, you're opening up the body, you're opening up a wound, the infection has got to be just something that you've got to watch constantly.
Yeah, for sure. And one of the things that happens is the skin is the most is one of the most important organs in our body. It's the largest organ in the body. It's our first barrier against the environment. So yeah, you have a high risk of infection. And obviously, the more the surface area is burned, that higher risk of infection will go for sure.
And the low blood volume, I would guess, comes with that dangerously low body temperature, though. That's interesting, because you have a burn victim here, and again, there's like a heat transfer, but then you have a low body temperature. Tell us about that and how.
So what will happen with the low body temperature, and this is mostly for larger burns, when we treat a burn, one of the parts of the treatment of the burn is stopping the burn. So you have to remove all the clothes. Unfortunately, some of the people tend to apply dressing, especially the initial provider. Some people will put ice or other cold things, and that will lead to low temperature, especially when you're exposing the patient or in the operating room, when you have to expose that large part of your body, the body will lose energy. So you lose the temperature, and that's how they become hypothermic. So we try to treat those patients in a warm situation. We have them warm rooms for them, warm operating rooms to prevent that loss of temperature.
And the breathing problems we saw, I mean, I would think that that would absolutely be part of it, because it all comes into play. Once you're burned at that stage, your body starts to work differently, shut down differently in certain areas, and you have to make sure that you're oxygenating the patient properly.
And the other thing that happens is, remember, when you're suffering, as you see smoke, there's a component, especially if you're in a confined place, there might be a component of smoke inhalation, or there might be even a degree of thermal injury and exchange or burns to your airways. So those will also compromise the capacity to breathe. So this is one of the things that we definitely have to be.
And scarring is part of that too, with the breathing problems.
Yeah, scarring is something that we'll see in a later stage. So this would be a late complication afterwards, especially depending on how the burns are treated, if they're treated appropriately or not. It will lead to a higher degree of scarring for sure.